Hawks go to Commonwealth Stadium with sportscasters Denny Treese and Tommy Bell.
As college football rivalries go, this is one of the granddaddies of them all, Kentucky against Tennessee, in a series dating all the way back to 1893. Hello, everybody. I'm Denny Treese, and I'd be willing to bet that even my well-traveled colleague, Tommy Bell, can't remember that 1893 game.
Well, Denny, I tell you, I'm as excited if I was working a Super Bowl today. This is really college football at its best. As you say, one of the all-time rivalries. I don't remember back to 1893, but I like to remember back when Kentucky's great Super Bowl team, as I call them, that won the Sugar Bowl, lost to Tennessee in the snow 7-0. Then I remember the game, the very 1953, when Bob Hardy was playing, and it's the first time they beat General Nayland's team under Coach Bryant, and didn't beat General Nayland, but the year after General Nayland resigned, and they handed off to Ralph Pallone, and it was a question whether Hardy's knee hit the ground or not, and whether it's a touchdown that won the game. And then I remember Bob Hardy the very next year throwing a touchdown pass in the end zone to Howard Snellenberger, and those rivalries go back, you know, it's just, as I say, sends cold chills down my spine just thinking about it.
I certainly remember the 1973 game, Coach Kersey's first year at Kentucky, when the Wildcats had a chance to win, but a field goal in the closing seconds fell just short, and the coveted beer barrel stayed in Knoxville for another year. Kentucky brought it home last year. The two coaches have been in kind of a philosophical mood this week, and we have the pregame comments of both men.
Well, it's been a good season regardless of the Tennessee game. I think these players have demonstrated week after week. They've played hard. They've played against some great opponents. They've done some remarkable things. And I guess it's got to go down as one of the most courageous teams they've ever coached. And with all the adversity they've overcome, and it's just a real outstanding team.
Two of the greatest things I think about this year is the support group of our people who've shown up strong every Saturday and been behind us. And been nothing negative, maybe. Thousands of letters I've received have been five or less negative. And also the way that our seniors have hung in there. Normally, seniors and fans about this time start writing off the days and counting the days to the last part of the season. And some of the supporters go Christmas shopping and think about Thanksgiving and go polish their hunting guns up. Our people have stood in there.
Well, despite just a 3-6 record at Tennessee this year, Coach Johnny Major is doing a pretty good job of keeping things in perspective down there, Tommy.
Yes, I think he is, Denny. When I spoke to the Knoxville Quarterback Club, I went by to see Coach Majors, and I handed him a list of all his Kentucky's injured and said, well, you may not be able to put 10 men on the field. And he said, don't kid me about Kentucky. I'm not even worried about Kentucky. I know I can't beat them. All I'm trying to do is win the state championship of Tennessee. But he didn't fool me. I'm sure he didn't fool you, and I know he didn't fool Coach Kersey. Because this game, the shoe is on the other foot. If Tennessee can beat Kentucky today, it will make their season, just like it used to be for Kentucky.
We'll be back with some special introductions in just a moment.
Even when payday comes at night, you can do all your banking on the way home with your personal banking card and Teller 24, the Anytime Bank. Deposit your paycheck, get some cash from checking, even make a loan payment. Each transaction is easy to make. How can you get Anytime Banking with Teller 24? That's easy, too. Just open a checking account at First National Bank.
Our wealth is good people. First National Bank.
How would you design your perfect beer? We designed one for bigger, better flavor. Falls City, when you're ready for a bigger taste in beer.
Now at Commonwealth Stadium, where another capacity crowd is on hand to watch the Kentucky Wildcats wind up what they hope will be one of the great seasons in Kentucky history, and Tennessee trying to avoid what they hope will be what they hope will not be the worst season in that school's history. This series, as we told you, dates back to 1893. Tennessee has won 43 games. Kentucky has won 20. There have been 9 ties over the years. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we would like to introduce to you the 17 seniors playing their final game in Kentucky blue and white here at Commonwealth Stadium today. First, from Lexington, Kentucky, defensive back Dallas Owens. from Coral Gables, Florida, defensive back Ron Kaysen. From Cincinnati, Ohio, defensive end Robert Murray. From Melbourne, Florida, linebacker Mike Martin. From Toledo, Ohio, defensive tackle Jerry Blanton. From Camden, New Jersey, defensive end Art Still. From Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, offensive guard Tom Dornbrook. From Crestview Hills, Kentucky, offensive guard Tim O'Toole. From Elyria, Ohio, offensive tackle Randy Kleineck. From Louisville, Kentucky, fullback Chuck Servino. From Boston, Massachusetts, center Will Grant. From Tompkinsville, Kentucky, place kicker Joe Bryant. From Fairdale, Kentucky, wide receiver Dave Prosper. From Erie, Pennsylvania, fullback Joe Dupre. From Camden, New Jersey, quarterback Derek Ramsey. From Parma Heights, Ohio, linebacker Jim Kovach. And from Norwalk, Connecticut, defensive back Mike Sagano. Thank you, seniors. Return with the opening kickoff immediately following these messages.
Big deals are being made at Thoroughbred Lincoln Mercury on brand new 1978s. Don Brown's large selection of Lincoln Mercurys is going to make you happy because the 78s are priced so low. The Bobcat, the Monarch, the all-new Zephyr, a very special car, the Cougar, Marquis, and the Lincoln Continental and Mark V's. Make your big deal at Thoroughbred Lincoln Mercury. You can count your savings, and that's the bottom line. Thoroughbred Lincoln Mercury, Preston Highway and Fern Valley Road.
You're watching the lifeblood of your car. Dalgard Coolant Antifreeze is available at all TUI's auto supply locations. To help you get that lifeblood flowing properly, each jug of Dalgard has illustrated instructions on how to change your antifreeze. Even if you've been doing it yourself, you may not be doing it right. When you go to TUI's auto supply and buy Dalgard Antifreeze, read it. Dalgard takes care of people who take care of their cars. Dalgard, available in all 12 TUI's auto supply locations in Kentucky. When your car goes fooey, call TUI.
Man, try one of our gigantic super-duper burgers on a bun with a little of our special sauce.
Tonight, we have one of my delicious steaks with a little bit of our special sauce.
At the Cow Palace, we don't need a lot of sauce for you to enjoy a good meal. Not only do our steaks taste great, they're good for you. And for $2.49, they're the greatest. Or if you need a little sauce, add it yourself. The Cow Palace, the steak store.
Kentucky will receive the opening kickoff here, and we'll set the offensive lineup for you. At tight end is Greg Nord, number 88, a 6'1", 217 senior from Louisville. Actually, he has another year of eligibility remaining, although he is technically a senior. The left tackle is Dan Fowler, number 61, a 6'4", 258 junior from Euclid, Ohio. The left guard, Tommy Kearns, number 75, a 6'3", 253 sophomore from Lexington. The center is Will Grant from Boston, 6'3", 238 a senior. The right guard, number 53, Tom Dornbrook, 6 foot, 227, senior from Pittsburgh. The right tackle, Larry Petkosic, from Seven Hills, Ohio, number 63, 6'5", 252, a junior. And the split end is Dave Prosper, 6'3", 205, senior, number 93, from Fairdale, Kentucky. The quarterback, Derek Ramsey, 6'5", 214, senior from Camden. He's number 12. The left halfback is Freddie Williams, 6 foot, 188, senior from Miami. The right halfback, Randy Brooks, number 45, 5'8", 185, sophomore, and Chris Hill, 5'10", 183, junior, number 22. They'll be alternating. The fullback, Joe Dupree, number 21, 6'1", a 217, senior from Erie, Pennsylvania, as the Tennessee Vols come onto the field.
But Denny, Kentucky won the toss and chose to receive, and Tennessee will be kicking. I don't know whether Johnny Majors is losing a little psychology because he came out on the field late. It's really game time, and the balls are just now coming on. Johnny leading them on with that orange sweater on, and I'm sure if he can win this game, it will make Tennessee's whole season for him. So I know when he talked in the dressing room, he says, this game, if we lose it, will be the losingest season Tennessee has ever had. And I know they do not want that. So it's going to be a tough game.
Jim Gaylor will kick off for Tennessee, 5'10", 185, senior from Nashville, number 9. And he's also their place-kicking specialist and a very good one. Back deep to receive for Kentucky, number 6, Dallas Owens, and number 26, Freddie Williams. Kentucky with a lot of their best athletes on that forward wall on the kickoff return team, including their All-America defensive end, Art Still. Beautiful day for football here in the Bluegrass.
Anyway, we've got a lot of wind with the kicker, so he ought to be able to get it to the end zone.
Gaylor gets this one about 3 yards deep, and Freddie Williams is not going to run it out. Kentucky will take over on the offense from the 20-yard line.
I think that was a wise choice. It wasn't a very good kick, but you could see how that wind took it in there, and I think Freddie made a wise choice of downing it and taking it on the 20.
Tennessee has given up 22 points per game this year. They've not been real successful defending against the rush, and Kentucky, of course, is a good rushing team.
Well, I presume we're going to get the rush right to start off, because that's usually Kentucky's practice, that they'll go to the run right away.
Derek Ramsey over center, Will Grant. Joe Dupree trying to pick his way up the middle, and he got just a couple. It was Danny Jenkins, the fine defensive tackle for Tennessee, who made the stop, 6'2", 220 senior from Elizabethton. Setting that defense for you, the middle guard is 60, Jim Noonan. The tackles are Jesse Turnbow, 79, and Jenkins, 68. The defensive ends, or outside linebackers, if you will, are Logan, 95, and David Barron, 94. Dennis Wolf will alternate at one of those outside spots, number 34. Second and 8 now. This is Randy Brooks on the sweep. He's got Dornbrook in front of him. Tries to cut it back up inside and gets nowhere. In fact, a loss of a yard. Kim Logan on the stop, number 95 for Tennessee.
Kim Logan made that original stop, but that looked like Kentucky's defense, the way they were swarming in good pursuit. Now, Coach Major says that Noonan, that middle guard, is all southeastern material, so we better watch him if we try to go over the middle.
The inside linebackers for the Vols, 43 Chris Bolton and 53 Greg Jones. Their second leading tackle from last year. He had 20 tackles against Kentucky last season. That's number 53, Greg Jones. Third and long yardage for Kentucky now. 9 to go for a first down. The draw play gets nothing, and Kentucky in a punting situation. It was Greg Jones in on the stop there for Tennessee as the balls come out fired up here.
I wish you hadn't mentioned that Greg Jones getting all those tackles. I think he just pulled him right in there to that draw. He diagnosed that well.
Tommy Bell's favorite number, number 7. Kevin Kelly on to punt for Kentucky, averaging 40 yards a boot on the year. This one is not too long. Bounces out of bounds near the midfield stripe. So great field position for the Tennessee Vols as they go on the attack now for the first time today.
Denny, that was only a 30-yard kick.
And there's time out on the field now. We'll return with more action following this message.
Welcome to Plainview Village Center. March on out with your family and friends and discover East Louisville's newest and finest shopping center. You'll find an extraordinary shopping experience waiting for you here, with an exciting, fun-filled parade of Louisville's finest shops and stores, and great restaurants worth all the fanfare. Come on out and see us. We promise the band won't be here. Plainview Village Center, off I-64 and Hurstburn Lane.
This is a full-size family car. This is the last full-size family Ford. And this is your last chance to own one at any price. V8, automatic, power steering, power brakes, white walls, full wheel covers, and factory air conditioning, all for $51.95. Let's look ahead. When this LTD is gone, What then?
Tennessee begins this drive in Kentucky territory at the 49-yard line, 13:26, showing on the Commonwealth Stadium clock. Jimmy Streeter is the quarterback. He gives it straight up the middle, and not much there.
That was Kentucky's swarming defense again. It's hard to give anybody credit for that tackle, but Jaffe was in there pretty tight and made a good job on it.
Gain of two, make it second and eight now. Jesse Briggs starting at the fullback spot for Tennessee, number 31. Kelsey Finch is the other running back, 36. Straight back to throw. Jimmy Streeter has his tight end, Reggie Harper, at the 40-yard line. Carl Murillo on the tackle for Kentucky. The linebacking corps has really been depleted. The Wildcats have had all kinds of injuries. Dave Podrowski and Kelly Kirchbaum have been limping all week. So Carl Murillo, sophomore from Louisville, in the hot seat today. He made the stop there on Reggie Harper, who has been Tennessee's leading receiver this year, a freshman. He now has 25 catches on the season. It's third and two, Tennessee. Middle they go to Jesse Briggs, and he has enough for the first down.
Well, Denny, Tennessee has taken it to Kentucky already now. On the first down, their team is fired up. We expected that the way they came out of that dressing room. So it's going to be up to the defense now to get on top like they always have.
Jerry Blanton, who has been limping on a cane all week, is starting on defense for Kentucky. But right now, it's first and 10 Tennessee on the 37-yard line. Jimmy Streeter on the option, keeps it himself and gets up to the 32-yard line. Whole host of blue shirts in on that tackle. Art Still getting off the bottom of the stack, big number 97, 6'7", 240 pounds. The tackles for Kentucky defensively are Ramey, 79, and Blanton, 92. The middle guard is Jaffe, number 58, and the other end, David Stevens, number 82. He'll alternate with Bud Deal, number 84.
Art Still did a good job turning that in besides getting the tackle.
Give Streeter a game of four, make it second and six now. Fumble, and Streeter has to fall on it himself. Earl Wilson in defensively for Kentucky was there to make sure that Streeter didn't go anywhere.
That's been one of Tennessee's real problems. Last week against Mississippi, when they were beaten so bad, they fumbled three times inside the 20-yard line. You're going to see this handoff, and the ball carrier just drops the ball, and if Streeter hadn't been alert, it could have been Kentucky's football.
Third down, 7 yards to go now with 10:49 showing on the clock. Streeter to throw again. Art Still on the rush, and he nailed it. Well, the big guy playing his final game here before the home folks. He's putting on a pretty good show already. Richard Jaffe got there to help him out once Art wrapped his big paw around Jimmy Streeter.
When we started this game, it was so funny. Martin, number 59, had 59 tackles. Jaffe, number 58, had 58. And Art Still had 41. He looks like he's going to try to catch up with him before the game's over, Denny.
Jim Gaylor on now to attempt a 57-yard field goal. He's 8 of 13 on the season. Looks like it's going to be short and off to the right side. But flags are down.
I believe it's going to be a penalty against Kentucky, offsides. That will still make it about fourth down and about eight, so it's not a crucial penalty, but it's not good to have. Because
it's going to give Jimmy Gaylor a much better shot at the field goal if he decides to try it.
Well, I'm sure he will. If he tried it from the 40-yard line, he's going to try it down from the 35, which will make it about a 52-yard kick now instead of 57. It may be more crucial than I think, Denny.
I'll tell you, Tommy, he wasn't 5 yards short on that last one.
No,
he was off to the right with it.
Yes, he was.
Billy Arbo will hold. Let's make it a 52-yarder. It's no good.
This one was off to the left, and the other one was off to the right.
So with 10 minutes still to play in the first half, there's a pause in the action with the score. Kentucky nothing and Tennessee nothing.
In 7 years, it costs its owner $20,000 to give about 100,000 miles of driving. The Waster produced tons of hydrocarbon particles, ozone, carbon monoxide, and other lethal gases. Guzzled 8,000 gallons of gasoline, enough to carry 46 bus riders at least 25 miles a day, 300 days a year for those 7 years. No wonder there's an energy crunch. There has to be an alternative.
Who's getting the interest on your checking account balance? It's your money. You should be. At Louisville Home Federal, there are special plans for individuals and businesses who dislike letting cash accumulate without interest, even for short periods of time. Our anytime availability and executive checking plans pay interest on your funds every day until you use them. At Louisville Home Federal, you get the extra slice.
Minutes remaining in the first quarter here at Commonwealth Stadium. Greg Nord switching positions there, going to the other side of the line, the tight end for Kentucky. Ramsey on the option, pitches it back to Freddie Williams, who juggled it and is knocked out of bounds.
I think Derek made a bad choice.
Kim Logan ran him out of bounds.
He really made a bad choice of laddering that ball in there near pitching it out because they were too close to the sideline. It was almost a fumble. You can watch now, Freddie Williams does a good job of picking this up. Derek has it there, and he doesn't have anywhere to go, but he might have cut back in. Now, you can see his pitch out, and he's a little bit behind Freddie, and Freddie did a super job of picking it up.
Scott Peterson, number 85, in at tight end for Kentucky. Prosper wide to the right side. Peterson goes to the left now. On second and eight, Tennessee jumps, and let's see. All kinds of flags flying.
I believe we're going to have a false start on Kentucky, Denny. Tennessee jumped, but I think it's Kentucky's left tackle that drew him, and that's a good call by the officials.
A left tackle for Kentucky is Danny Fowler, the strongest man on the team. He can lift the whole line in one hand. Danny's got the ability to, well, he can do something that most of us wish we could do. That's put on and take off weight practically at will. He played as a high school junior at tackle at 260, and when he got to be a senior, he was a 200-pound tight end and fullback. Now he's back up there to 258. He made a boo-boo there and has made it a second to 13 situation for Kentucky. 9:53 to go, first period. Randy Brooks got back to the 19-yard line. Had to do some pretty fancy squirming to get there. Jesse Turnbow, the biggest man on the Tennessee defense, at the bottom of that stack. Turnbow is 6'8", 267 pounds, a senior from Cincinnati.
He is one big hunk of man, Denny. That's the only really big defensive lineman Tennessee has, but they really have a lot of quickness. And they've taken it to Kentucky this first quarter, and they're fired up, and it's going to be a fine ball game.
Third and 11 with Felix Wilson wide to the left. Let's see if Kentucky goes to the air. Well, again, the defense jump. Let's see what the story is this time. Turnbow kept right on going toward Ramsey. Now he's having a discussion with Tommy Dornbrook. Tom, that's a mismatch, my friend. Tommy goes 6 foot 227 and Turnbow 6'8", 267.
Yes, that is a mismatch. I believe we're going to have Tennessee offside this time. Their lineman jumping. I didn't see that's right. It's Tennessee offside. There was no movement on the Kentucky line that time. The balls just came off. You can see it on the instant replay that there was no movement on the Kentucky line, and had a little discussion with Turnbow and Ramsey back there, and Tommy Dornbrook picked it up, but as Denny said, Tommy's outmatched in size there. He better use a little discretion when he picks on Turnbow.
So let's make it third and six now with the ball on the 24-yard line with 9:15 to go, first period. Ramsey rolling left. He's going to run it. First down, Kentucky. Clark Duncan got there from his defensive safety spot for Tennessee, but not before Derek got enough for the first down.
That was a typical Derek Ramsey run. He looked like he was going to be stopped short of the first down. Then he picked up five additional yards, and it wasn't certainly any bad defensive play by Tennessee, but just a great play by Derek Ramsey. You can see now when he takes out there onto the left, he's got a chance to either throw, but it looks like a run to me all the way there on the replay. And Ramsey's going to make it on that first down with a lot of running to do it.
From the 33, Dupree up the middle. And he runs as he always does with reckless abandon and gets almost to the 38-yard line before Jim Noonan, the middle guard, brought him down.
Noonan made a great play then. He was blocked very well by Will Grant, but he still fended it off and still came back to get that tackle just for a three-yard gain.
Give Joe Dupre a gain of closer to four. We'll make it second and six.
I believe you're right. I apologize to you.
Felix Wilson now out wide to the right side. Plenty of time for Ramsey. Uses a good block from Freddie Williams and got a couple of more to the 39.
This looked like a rollout pass play this time, and Derek was going to pass, but he didn't have anybody open, and I think he used good discretion in running, but Tennessee's defense was just too tough, and he only picked up about a yard. You can see as he comes out, he's looking for his pass receiver all the time. I don't believe he's thinking about running this time. He's hesitating, nobody open, and he does finally have to run it. He looked twice, and nobody there.
They have spotted it at the 38, so it'll be third and five. Trosper split out just a few yards to the right side. Everybody else in tight. Ramsey takes it to the three, pitches wide to Brooks. Knocked out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage. Junior Reed came up from his cornerback spot and made a big hit. Junior Reed, a freshman, 5'11 from Humboldt, Tennessee, and he has forced Kentucky into another punting situation. Roland James back deep to receive. Kevin Kelly on to punt it for Kentucky.
Well, I tell you, that kid from Humboldt, Tennessee reminds me of Doug Atkins the way he played that play, even though he's not near as big.
A big rush. Kelly gets it away and goes down on a heap. No flag.
The referee made a discretion then that his movement caused that to be. The own movement of the kicker caused him to go into the Tennessee man, and it's one of those calls you could call either way, Denny, and he did not call it.
Tommy, you don't see roughing the kicker call quite as much as you used to.
I think you're right, because you have so much movement of the kicker, and so many of those kickers giving you an Academy Award. And he didn't give an Academy Award, but I think his movement took him into him. I think he made a good decision on not calling that roughing the kicker.
Kelly Kirchbaum is in at linebacker now, number 51 for Kentucky, so it's Kirchbaum and Martin manning the linebacking spot. Jesse Briggs on the carry for Tennessee. Got across the 35 to about the 36-yard line. David Tupskin Stevens on the hit. Give him a gain of four, make it second and six now from the 37-yard line. 7:37 to play, first period. Briggs and Finch are the setbacks behind Jimmy Streeter. Streeter pitching back to Kelsey Finch. Put on a good move. Open field in front of him. Finally, drug down at the 45 in Kentucky territory. Jerry Blanton had to chase him down.
That was a great run by Finch that time. You know, last year he started out being one of the finest runners in the Southeastern Conference, and he showed it to us then. And if it hadn't been for Jerry Blanton's speed, good knee or bad knee, that might have been all the way.
Blanton is going out now, and Earl Bubba Wilson, the big freshman, in to replace him. Wilson, 6'4", 245. Kelsey Finch again. Diving forward to the 40-yard line. Dallas Owens came up to hit him.
Dallas came up well there. In fact, he came up well. He was on the right side before Kelsey Finch's run. He came up, forced him inside, and thought he was going to get the tackle, but good running by Kelsey Finch just got away from Dallas Owens.
Second and five now. Briggs up the middle. Earl Wilson put him down after a gain of a couple.
Big Earl just stood up there and just said, come to me, and hugged him, didn't he? I noticed Kentucky's defense, they're putting Dallas Owens head and head on Arbo no matter where he goes. So I guess Coach Kersey and Coach Bailey really feel like that Arbo is their dangerous receiver.
Billy Arbo is number two, 6'1", 195, a junior. Jeff Moore wide to the left side now, but Arbo in the slot to the left. Streeter on that option play again. Back to Kelsey Finch. Larry Carter upended him just short of the 30-yard line. Kelsey Finch dove forward across that 30. Let's see where they spot it.
It's going to be a first down, Denny, by about 4 yards. So that was a fine run on K Kelsey Finch, and a fine play by Streeter this time. Streeter held that ball well, and not anything wrong with Kentucky defense. That's just good Tennessee play there, and Finch is turning it on. He looks like the back that he was supposed to be last year.
First and 10 from the 30. Streeter faked the pitch to Finch that time, kept it himself, and got just a yard. Dallas Owens came up from the monster spot with help from Art Still.
Dallas really turned it in right into Art, and then he couldn't go anywhere right after Dallas turned it in. That's fine defensive play by Kentucky.
4:50 remaining in the first period. We're scoreless at Commonwealth Stadium.
WHAS-TV Louisville.
Farrell back to Lexington last year after a thrilling 7-0 victory. Down at Neyland Stadium, a long pass play from Dallas Owens to Greg Woods, the only score in that ball game. Streeter to Finch again. Owens again came up to make the hit.
Art Still made a great play then. He forced that pitch. Streeter couldn't do anything. Then Art helped Dallas finish him off. That looked like an All-American tackle that time. Can't play it any better than that, Denny. You just can't play the defense any better.
So a 3rd-and-7 situation. But at worst, Jim Gaylor should get a try at another field goal if they can't get the first down here. Quick count. Briggs running hard across the 20-yard line, enough for the first down.
That was an excellent call by the Tennessee quarterback then, a draw play. Everybody in the stadium expected him to pass, and he called that draw, and Briggs just made a fine run.
Let's set that line for you for Tennessee. The tight end, Reggie Harper, 85. The tackles, Watson, 62. Ralph Bullard, 72. The guards are Scott Fair, 77. Charlton Webb, 64. The center, Robert Shaw, 56. One of the best in the conference. On 1st-and-10 from the 18 now. Streeter on that option, runs it oh so well. Look at those quick feet down at the 5-yard line. Larry Carter put him down.
Another first down, Denny. This was a fine run by Streeter. He just cut it in there, and when he cut, he was really mojoing. He picked up speed, and that's the mark of a great football player. That's a fine run, and if it hadn't been a good tackle there, he would have gone all the way.
First and goal from the 5. Streeter again, just diving forward for perhaps a yard. A lot of blue shirts on top of him there. Art Still is on there, and Bubba Wilson on the stack also. Excuse me, Tom.
Streeter used good judgment then, Denny, because Dallas Owens came up and really had that pitch cut out. I think if he'd pitched it, Dallas might have intercepted it. So he just took his 1-yard gain, and that was good football by Mr. Streeter.
Well, Kentucky has one of the toughest goal line defenses around. It's going to be put to the test right here as Arbo comes wide to the left. Jeff Moore wide right. Two setbacks behind Jimmy Streeter on 2nd and goal. Streeter pitches it back. Finch fumbled the football but dove on in for the touchdown. Tennessee has lit up the scoreboard first at Commonwealth Stadium with 2:14 to go in the first period. Tennessee leads 6-0 on the touchdown by Kelsey Finch.
I want to tell you, that's a great play by their quarterback. Finch's run was great, but Dallas Owens just about knocked his teeth out just as he had let loose of that ball. And for him to make as good a pitch as he did, he has to be a fine football player.
Jim Gaylor, who's 18 of 18 from the year, not going to get a chance at this one. Gaylor picks up the football, and he's put down.
Well, Tennessee had a strange lineup then. I don't know what they were planning on doing.
Well, it's timeout in Lexington with the score. Tennessee 6 and Kentucky nothing.
Trying to steal home with a great deal? You're safe at Perkins.
Watch as power-driven air browns and cooks meats faster, juicier, in this extraordinary Gen Air power oven. And the extraordinary Gen Air grill range rotisses, griddles, and grills meat, venting smoke and odors direct to outdoors. Meat cooks the way you want it with the extraordinary Gen Air grill range.
See your local Gen Air appliance dealer today. If you're an innocent victim of crime and have financial hardship, Kentucky's Crime Victim Compensation Board may be able to help you with your medical expense and lost earnings.
For information, contact Crime Victims Compensation Board, 113 East 3rd Street, Frankfort, 40601.
Tennessee out in front here, 6-0 with 2:14 remaining in the first period. Jim Gaylor to kick off now for the Vols.
Well, Denny, they went 63 yards then in about 5 minutes and 16 seconds, so they're ready to play.
Out she goes.
It'll be a touchback. It went into the end zone. It'll be Kentucky's ball on the 20-yard line. I tell you, the Vols really put it down Kentucky's throat then, and their defense has been one of the greatest all year, but the Vols let them show that they had a great offense. So this is really going to be the ball game that we expected before this game started, Denny. This is one of those games where Tennessee came up here to win, and they're going to be playing it right to the hill.
Dallas Owens, the big, valuable senior quarterback, barking signals. Joe Dupree scrambling for all he can. He's got about 4 yards. Jim Noonan, the middle guard, on the stop.
Jim Noonan is a tough football player. I can see why Johnny Majors thinks he should be all Southeastern Conference. We think our Jaffe's great, but Noonan's playing just as good as Jaffe's been playing all year.
They're built a lot alike, very low to the ground. Noonan, 5'9", 206 from Dyersburg, Tennessee. Second and 7 now. Ramsey threading his way across the 25 to the 26-yard line. Hit by Chris Bolton, the freshman linebacker out of Atlanta.
Now this is a big down for Kentucky. They got third and about 3. And it's a crucial first down, because if they don't get something going now, the momentum is going to stay with Tennessee.
Let's see if he'll test that young backfield. The corner is Roland James, 14, a sophomore, Junior Reed, a freshman, number 30. Another freshman, Clark Duncan, at the safety spot. Ramsey throwing for Felix Wilson. He's got him for a Kentucky first down. Wilson knocked out of bounds by Roland James.
Denny, I want to tell you, that was a great pass, and it's also a great catch by Wilson. Derek Ramsey rolled out well, and I thought maybe he might run it, but then he spotted Felix Wilson on just a down-and-out pattern. He threw it where it couldn't be intercepted, and Wilson just made a super catch.
Mike Deaton, a freshman from Greene County, in for Kentucky now, number 1 at quarterback. Ramsey is out. Deaton, 6'1", 180, a sophomore. With just a minute showing on the scoreboard clock here in the first period. First and 10, Kentucky. Joe Dupree fumbled the football, got it back. He just reached up over his shoulder pads and brought the ball down, but no gain on the play. Chris Bolton, the linebacker, hit him just as he grabbed the football.
That so often happens, I think, when a new quarterback comes in. He didn't get a good hold on the ball, and his handoff was high, but Joe Dupree sure did a good job of holding on to that ball.
Felix Wilson, the man who caught that first down pass, is back in now, and Trosper is out. Wilson has caught 3 touchdown passes this year while alternating with Trosper. He's been a valuable receiver. Second and 10 from the 38. Joe Dupree gets up to the 40, and that's all. So it'll be third and long yardage for Kentucky here. Another tackle for Jim Noonan.
Some of the fans are upset, I think, with maybe the officials in. They let some of the Tennessee men come in late, but I think they stopped it pretty quickly. Now here comes Ramsey back in the game.
The nose of the football, not quite up to the 40-yard line. Doubtful that Kentucky will get another playoff and miss the first period. Clock winding down, and there's the horn. That's the end of the first period with the score. Tennessee 6 and Kentucky nothing. Well, the Kentucky cheerleaders look happy, but they can't be too excited about the score right now. Tennessee 6, Kentucky nothing as we begin the second period at Commonwealth Stadium.
Well, there's no doubt about it. That first period was Tennessee over Kentucky. They outplayed Kentucky offensively and defensively. Now Kentucky's had one first down and going into this quarter, and they've got another really crucial third and about 9. This is even more crucial than that other third down pass that Ramsey completed to a first down for Wilson. So it's up to the Cats to keep this drive going, or again, I say, Tennessee will still have the momentum.
Derek Ramsey always seems to find a way to make that crucial first down when the Cats need it. Let's see what he can pull out of the hat here. Two blockers in front of him. Ramsey cuts up inside, has enough for the first down. He's done it again, Tommy.
Yep. That was Noonan again that made the tackle, but the Kentucky's offensive backfield was so, if you look this on the replay, they line up three backs way over to the left. That's the first time I've seen them done that. They just decided to put backfield left and run backfield left with Ramsey right behind him, and he made that first down. As you say, he sure is crucial on those first down plays.
I wonder if they call that play in the huddle student body left.
It was almost student body left right there.
Felix Wilson goes wide to the right now for Kentucky with the ball in the 45-yard line, Tennessee territory. Joe Dupree running hard, still on his feet, finally brought down at the 31-yard line.
That's one of the best runs that Joe Dupree's made this year. He came through there, and I'm telling you, he had a little slight hole, and after he hit through there, he just moved you on down there. He didn't even stop to say boo turkey spit, didn't he? He just went right on.
Tommy Dornbrook and Randy Brooks leading the blocking there. They knocked people all around.
Kentucky's picked up the momentum now, and you can tell the way the fans are reacting, too. They were pretty quiet for a while.
First and 10 from the 31. Ramsey on the roll. Look at him ramble. Knocked out of bounds, close to the 15-yard line. Jim Noonan had to get there again. I tell you, when Derek Ramsey gets rolling, Tommy, it's like trying to tackle a mobile home.
Well, Ramsey's a lot faster than it appears the way he's running. You know, he watch him when he gets on this corner, and it looks like he might be tackled or picked up from the rear, and he just takes off. And when he takes off, he cuts inside that one Tennessee man, and just a great run. That's all I can say about it.
Another Kentucky first down at the 17-yard line. 14:04 to go, second period. Randy Brooks slicing into the line. Pushed back by Big Jesse Turnbow.
Turnbow is really a fine-looking football player, and I know he's going to be one of Tennessee's best. And he's just such a big guy that it's hard to run over him.
Get a good look at the Kentucky huddle there with Derek Ramsey explaining the situation to his men. Good shot at the offensive line. Tommy Kearns, 75-61. Dan Fowler. Freddie Williams may go all the way. He's in for the touchdown. A 15-yard touchdown gallop by Fast Freddie Williams, and Kentucky now has tied it up.
That woke the Kentucky fans up, Denny. Williams, when he got to that goal line, hit in there between two men. I wish you would watch this run. When he gets to about the 4-yard line, there was no denying him. Two Tennessee tacklers hit him hard. Not anything wrong with the tackling. You can't play it any better than that in defense. That's just an extraordinary play by Freddie Williams.
Now it's up to the Tompkinsville toe, Joe Bryant, number 20, to try to put Kentucky out in front. Joe Bryant this year has connected on 20 of 25. He said it was his boyhood dream to play at Kentucky. He can put the final chapter of that dream together this afternoon. Playing his final game, he put it squarely through the uprights. Kentucky goes in front 7-6. There's a pause in the action, and we'll be right back.
Perkins, Chrysler's, and Plymouth's, along with a nifty family van. Service and savings up Dixie. It's Perkins People Pleasing Plan. Perkins oils the wheels of wheeling and dealing. A better shake for folks like you and me. So steer yourself to lower prices, 'cause Perkins will take less, you see. Perkins will take less, you see.
Sometimes it seems that Uncle Sam gets more than his share in taxes. Louisville Home Federal may be able to help you pay less in taxes this year while you build a secure, maybe even wealthy future through an individual retirement account, or IRA. If your last income tax payment was way out of line, maybe you should see the IRA experts at Louisville Home Federal before the end of the year. Then this time, you can give more to yourself and your IRA and less to the IRS.
If for some strange reason you're just joining us, Kentucky leads Tennessee early in the second period, 7-6. They've all scored first on a 4-yard run by Kelsey Finch. Kentucky tied it up on a 15-yard run by Freddie Williams. Joe Bryant's extra point put Kentucky in front. Here's the kick. Moore at the 5. Good hard running back almost to the 30-yard line.
That was a good running back. You told me Moore before the game, Denny's one of their best runners, and boy, he showed it there.
Gary Moore leads the Southeastern Conference in kickoff returns, averaging 29 per return. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well, Kentucky went 80 yards for that touchdown, and it only took them 3 minutes and 48 seconds. It started with 2:14 in the first quarter.
Quick look-in pass. What a catch by Reggie Harper, the tight end. Now they say no. He bobbled it once, dove, and made the catch, but ruled incomplete.
This is a tough call. Let's see how it looks on the replay. He sure made a dive for it. They're saying that he trapped it on the ground, and that's just a judgment call. That's tough to call.
Reggie Harper was an all-state football and basketball player in high school. He showed some real athletic ability there, even getting his hands on that a second time. Second and 10 from the 29 now. Pretty good running by Jesse Briggs as he got to the 33.
Well, then, as I said, that Kentucky drive was 80 yards. It started with 2:14 left in the first quarter and ended with 13:48, I guess it was. I didn't write that down, but pretty close. And altogether, it was 3:48 that it took them to go 80 yards, and that's a pretty daggone good football.
Possession play, Tennessee, third and six now from the 34. Jimmy Streeter on the option. Pitches back to Finch. Nothing there. Dallas Owens is coming up so quick from his monster or rover back position, Tommy.
Well, Dallas Owens is a real pro prospect, and he showed it today. He's played that position just perfect, and he has such quick speed that he can come up fast like that and still be back there for that pass coverage. Kentucky has picked the momentum up now, Denny.
Craig Colquitt on to punt. Kentucky for the second week in a row facing one of the best punters in the nation. Colquitt ranks third in the country right now. Oh, Johnny Bow hit hard to 30, somehow bounces out of there, but not much room for him to run and get away. He was really hit by Kelsey Finch. There's time out on the field now, and we'll return with more action following this.
That was a 36-yard kick, and we're going to have a penalty against Tennessee for 15 yards for unnecessary roughness, so that's going to really put Kentucky in good field position.
So instead of the 29-yard line, let's spot it at the 44 of Kentucky.
I couldn't pick up the Tennessee man that made that late hit on Johnny Bow, but you called it just perfect. He was hit and looked like he was going to go down, but how he held his feet, I don't know. And then he took off to the sideline, and there was a swarm of volunteers, and the flag went down, and then we had our commercial.
Same three backs behind Derek Ramsey with Dave Prosper wide to the left side. Pass Freddie Williams on the run again, and Freddie is having quite a day. He got about 9 there with good blocking on that right side.
That was good blocking and good running. And I tell you, I'd like to see that student body left again since they're on that right side of the field. Put all those backs over here to the left and let Derek roll out again.
They've spotted it at the 49, so give him a gain of 7. Make it 2nd and 3. Clock moving at 11:34. This is Ramsey. A first down and then some.
He picked up 5 yards on his own. I think that was a misplay in the quarterback. He went to hand off and he wasn't there, so he just turned to his right, and let's see what it looks like. No, I guess it wasn't. It was a play because he wasn't trying to hand it off. That was a play. That's almost a bootleg play. I thought Derek had missed handoff and just made 5 on his own. That's a good play.
Tommy Kearns, the guard, looked like he knew where he was going.
He
all
sure
the way
did.
He was going to try to get out there and make a block.
It was a play all the way. I miscalled it the first time when I saw it.
First and 10 Wildcats on the 43-yard line now.
That's student body right.
Ramsey knocked down after a gain of a couple by Greg Jones, the linebacker from Bristol, Tennessee. He's a good one, 6'2", 210.
Kentucky's shifting from that T, then, and it looks like the old Notre Dame shift when I was playing. You know, they just shifted all 3 of those backs over to make it student body right, as you called it, and they didn't pick up that much as they did on the other.
Nose of the football not quite up to the 42-yard line, so let's call it 2nd and 9. Joe Dupree bullying his way up the middle. Danny Jenkins, a fine defensive tackle for Tennessee, in on that stop again.
Danny, we're coming up to 3rd down and 5, and this is the 3rd time Kentucky's had a crucial 3rd down. The first 2 times they made it. One of them on a pass to Felix Wilson, one of them on Derek Ramsey run. So this is the 3rd one. If they can get this one, they may really have the momentum.
That young lady looked a little concerned about whether or not Kentucky can get it. Third and four. Williams is going to try to get it. Flags are down.
Tennessee's right cornerback was offsides. I don't know what the other flag for, but the Tennessee's right cornerback jumped and really almost lined up offsides instead of jumping.
And the monster man, Chip Lineberry, looked like he wanted to come on a blitz, and he just stepped across that neutral zone, Tommy.
It's very possible that we might have offsetting penalties here. No, it's offsides against Tennessee. But we had one flag on this side of the field and one on the other, so that's a big break to Kentucky because that's going to be a first down, I believe.
They had 4 yards to go for the first down, so it should be automatic.
Well, now, Tennessee's had two crucial penalties on this drive that Kentucky started, and it first was the 15-yard penalty on Johnny Bell when he was tackled down there on about the 28. And then now this 5-yard penalty gave Kentucky a first down when they may not have made it, and it didn't look like Freddie Williams did make it.
Brooks diving forward after the block by Joe Dupree almost to the 26-yard line. Kim Logan knocked him out with help from Greg Jones, the linebacker.
Joe Dupree made a fine block on this play, and it's just one of those kind of a situations that Randy Brooks didn't have anywhere to run even after a fine block. Usually a block like this might spring you loose, but Tennessee had some great defensive play, and Randy really had some good hard running to pick up that 5 yards.
Trosper going very wide to the right side now on second and five. The backs of the straight T formation. Joe Dupree, the fullback, gets to the 25-yard line. Jesse Turnbow at the bottom of that stack.
There's an old expression again. We have another crucial third down, and it's third and about two. Now, it may not be as crucial because I believe if Kentucky doesn't make it, they'll still go for it. On fourth down, or possibly have a field goal attempt.
Well, it's Wilson wide right now. Ramsey trying to draw him off. It's Dupree up the middle.
I think the Tennessee man got back, and it's still a first down, though, for the Cats.
Greg Jones and Danny Jenkins combining for the stop for Tennessee.
He didn't get back. The head linesman called him offside. I thought he'd gotten back, but the head linesman has a better view than I do. So Kentucky will take the penalty because that 5 yards will be more than what Joe picked up.
The officials for today's game, the referee Jim Harper Jr., the umpire James Pratt, the linesman Joe Curtis, the line judge Ed Dudley, the field judge John Fleming, the back judge Pat McHugh.
Well, Kentucky picked that one up on a run anyway. The penalty didn't help them but about a yard or two, but they had a first down anyway, Denny. So the other penalty, though, was very crucial to Tennessee.
9:04 before halftime. Freddie Williams on the carry. He is having himself one fine day. Jim Noonan had to bring him down, but not before. Freddie Williams got it almost to the 10-yard line. They're going to spot it at the 12.
Freddie's running like he did down at LSU. You know, I told you I was very much surprised. I didn't realize he was that good a running back. I knew he was a great blocker, but he's even running better today than he did down at LSU, I think.
He has that ability, Tommy, to turn his body sideways and just slide through the hole.
He sure does, and doesn't lose any speed doing it.
Felix Wilson to the right side. Everybody else in tight. Ramsey to Randy Brooks. Look at that hole. Tommy Dornbrook made a good block, and Brooks took it inside the five. They'll spot it at the 3-yard line. Junior Reed, the freshman defensive back, had to make the hit on him.
Well, I'll tell you, this is a good block, not only by, as you said, you called it right to Dornbrook, but Williams gets a good block on this play, too. And that really helps make it. He cut his legs right out on front and took him down for about 3 more yard gain.
First and goal, Kentucky from the 3. 8:08 to play, first half. Now they've got Freddie Williams on the wing to the right side. Dupree and Brooks, the setbacks behind Ramsey. This is Joe Dupree for another yard.
They ran at the big man. I don't know whether he was on the bottom of the stack, but he was sure in there, and that's tough running. I don't think he picked up, they gave him about a quarter of a yard there, Denny, maybe a length of the football. Didn't look like Joe picked up anything.
He'll be generous and make it second and goal from the 2. Joe Dupree very close.
The officials are going to mark it about 6 inches, as you can see the line judge going up there on your screen, and he is putting the ball about 6 inches from the goal line.
Danny Jenkins in on the stop. Johnny Chavis is in there now, too, on that goal line defense for Tennessee. 5'10", 220, junior number 46 from Dillon, South Carolina.
You fans might watch your line judge and your head linesman. When they come up there and don't signal touchdown, you know they're not going to give it to the offensive team. But if those hands go up immediately, then you know it's in there.
Ramsey himself still fighting. He got over. That was second and third and fourth effort, and somehow Derek Ramsey took it in, and Kentucky leads now by the score of 13-6. Joe Bryant will try to make it 14 with 6:46 remaining in the first half.
I want to tell you, Coach Kersey's comments on Ramsey, he's going to find some way to get it in there. He's that such a competitor and such a great athlete. As Denny called it, it was first, second, third, and fourth effort when he finally got into that end zone. Just a stupendous play, Derek Ramsey.
Joe Bryant now from the hold of Billy Williams. Placed down perfectly and kicked through perfectly. Kentucky leads 14-6. There's timeout in Lexington, and we'll be right back.
Citizens Fidelity didn't invent freedom, but we have found a way to bring you more of it with Service Tree Banking. Check and save at Service Tree's growing at Consolidated Sales and just about every convenient food mart in town. Get the new freedom of Service Tree Banking by opening a checking and savings account at Citizens Fidelity. And don't forget to follow through.
With 6 minutes and 46 seconds remaining now in the first half, Kentucky on top of Tennessee by the score of 14-6. And we've already seen a lot more points scored today than we saw in Knoxville last year, Tommy.
That's right, Denny. That was a 71-yard drive, if you're going to count that 15-yard penalty on Johnny Bow. And Kentucky is really taking it now, 80 yards and 71 yards, and that's putting it right down the Vols' throat. They've got to come back now if they're going to get back in this ball game.
Joe Bryant got that one up in the wind, and Gary Moore is not going to bring it back. So that's one way to stop the good run backs of Gary Moore. Kick it deep enough that he can't run it back.
The way Gary Moore ran that first one back, I was glad to see Joe Bryant, since I'm a Kentucky fan, and I know you Tennessee fans would love to have seen him run that back, because he is a great kickoff returner. The Volunteers are going to have to pick it up now if they get back in this football game. Kentucky's taking over the momentum, and I believe Johnny Majors will throw out all stops, and I believe the Vols will be putting it to Kentucky.
This is Nate Sumter up the middle. He got about three. Kelly Kirchbaum on the hit. Nate Sumter in at fullback now for Tennessee, a 5'11", 194 junior from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Very highly recruited player out of South Carolina. And he's in now at fullback.
I thought Kelly Kirchbaum made a fine play then. Didn't look like he could get to the hole, but he did, and ended up stopping it for about a 3.5 to 4 yard gain.
Arbo in the slot to the left side now with Ken Sanderson wide left. Streeter still got it. Art Still puts him down.
Art Still played that like an All-American tackle again. And Kelly Kirschbaum was right there if Art should have missed him.
Great fake for the quarterback there to Sumter up the middle, Tommy. He had everybody fooled except Art Still.
He sure did. And I tell you, Kelly Kirschbaum may look like he's hurt his shoulder. I hope that's not so. But he's holding his left shoulder, and he kind of came down hard on it right after Art made that tackle.
Very hard-nosed football player, Kelly Kirschbaum. Third and three now. Big play for Tennessee. They need some momentum at this point. Jimmy Streeter cuts it back up inside and gets enough for the first down. Richard Jaffe had a shot at him, Tommy, but just couldn't change directions there.
Well, that was a good play by Richard, but a greater play by the quarterback, Streeter. This was a fine third down play with the pressure on why they made it, and that made the Volunteers make that first down. That may give them some momentum now, and they may take it to us.
First and 10 from the 32, 5 minutes and 19 seconds showing on the clock, and it's running. Nate Sumpter, the fullback, diving across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
Boy, he impressed me with that run there. There wasn't much to go at all, and he sure just plowed that thing in there for a four-yard gain.
Jaffe and Martin and Still all had a hand in that tackle for Kentucky. Second and six now.
Where is Sumpter from?
South Carolina, Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Kelsey Finch on the carry. Richard Jaffe there with Big James Ramey helping out.
Well, that was another good run. Now, that's two good runs of Tennessee backs. Finch and Sumpter have just made about 8 yards on their own, 4 yards a crack. And Kentucky's defense played it hard, played it well. But that's just great play by Tennessee.
So another possession play here for the Tennessee Vols. Jimmy Streeter, the quarterback, out over center. Third and two. Kelsey Finch hit just as he got the ball by Richard Jaffe, and it's going to be very, very close.
It looks like where the officials are marking, it's going to be short, about a ball's length and in. He hit in there hard, but it's fourth down.
Jaffe hit him first, and then Martin was there to help out with a lot of other blue shirts. Craig Colquitt on to punt now.
We won't even have a measurement.
Craig Colquitt this year is averaging 45.8, Tommy.
That is tremendous, you know, and he's kicking into the wind. The last time he had a 35-yard kick into that wind, and let's see what he does now.
A line drive kick that Johnny Bow tries to field, and it's dropped, and Tennessee has the football. Johnny Bow, very indecisive, Tommy. He just didn't seem to know whether to go for it or not.
Well, I'm sure Johnny will tell you, he made a mistake, Denny. He should have gotten away from that football, and I think he will be the first to tell you, and that's a big break for Tennessee because they've got the ball now in Kentucky's 21.
It looked like Brent Watson, who got on that football, 6'5", 250 senior from Twin Falls, Idaho, for Tennessee.
That's the first real break of the football game and the first turnover that I recall.
From the 21. Nate Sumpter. He's down to about the 18-yard line. Richard Jaffe again putting the hit on him. We've got two tremendous middle guards in this football game, Tommy, and Richard Jaffe and Jim Noonan.
We sure do. I thought Jaffe just made an extraordinary play on that one, and Noonan has been making them all day, so I don't think you'll find two better nose guards than we've watched today.
On second and seven now, Kelsey Finch, hard running. Jerry Blanton had a hold of him, but Finch just wouldn't be stopped. He got it inside the 15, close to the 13-yard line.
You know, Johnny Majors also said he thought Shaw was one of the finest centers that he'd ever coached, and so that means that Jaffe is playing against a great football player himself right there, and maybe we can say that he's playing a little bit better than Noonan, but I can't say it because Kentucky's got a great center in Will Grant.
Tennessee has turned out some super centers over the years. Remember Bob Johnson?
Oh, do I ever. Playing for the Bengals now.
Kelsey Finch again. But it'll depend on what they give him in the way of forward progress, Tom.
It's going to be very close for a first down, and I think they'll probably have to measure it this time. No, they're calling it fourth down. It's not as far as that I thought he went. They didn't give him as much forward progress as I thought.
When Mike Martin got a hold of Kelsey Finch, he just would not let him go any further, pushed him backwards, and it is less than a yard short. Timeout now in Lexington with the score, Kentucky 14, Tennessee 6.
BMW. Motor cars. Rich in tradition. Have you experienced the mystique of a personal vehicle, blending man with machine in unique oneness, different as today, daring as tomorrow? Drive one, be different. BMW, the ultimate driver's machine. Call me today at MS Imports, 4th Breckenridge.
Allowed only 6 first downs to Tennessee down in Knoxville last year, and this is one they don't want to give up right here. 4th and 1 from the 12.
Well, Tennessee's offense has played mighty fine football today, and I'm kind of afraid as a Kentucky fan they're going to take advantage of this, and I expect them to make this first down.
Kentucky ranks 7th in the nation in defense. Fans on their feet. Kelsey Finch has got it.
He's got it. That was a good call, and it was kind of a cross butt, the fake to his left, and then gave Kelsey Finch coming right over the center. And Shaw made a fine block on Jaffe, as you can see it. Very fine play. I had a feeling that Tennessee would make that thing.
So first and goal at the 9. They're going to have to take it 9 yards in here. They cannot get another first down without scoring. Streeter back to Finch. And he's in for the score. Kelsey Finch, 9 yards for a touchdown, and Tennessee is back within a point.
I want to also give Streeter another pat on the back for another fine play at quarterback. He held it to the last second, was hit hard, and then pitched out to Finch. It was almost a very duplicate of the first touchdown that they ran in the first quarter. And that Finch has lots of speed, lots of speed. Kelly Kirschbaum has a lot of speed, but he went off and left him then.
Kelsey Finch, 6'1", 207 junior from Sheffield, Alabama.
Now, what does the book say? Does it say go for 2?
Well, I kind of look for Johnny Majors to go for the 2-point conversion here. I really do.
Now, last week you told me when it was 14-12, it was the book said go for 2.
A lot of coaches will tell you it is automatic. Bear Bryant at Alabama is one of those. He says if you've got 12 points, it's automatic. Fran Kersey does not quite believe in that. He's got a computer that he subscribes to, Tommy, that has certain situations that'll tell you when to go for 2 and when it would be better to go for 1. And he says 12 is not automatic. He won't always go for 2. Let's see what Johnny Majors will do.
I'll bet you a steak dinner he goes for 2. I think he's almost have to, because even if he doesn't make it, that doesn't hurt his momentum, and it gives the kids that drive that they know their coach wants to tie this football game up and get them back in. And even if they miss it, it's not going to be downhearted.
Right, a field goal can still get them back in front if they should miss here.
Sure.
So I see no reason whatsoever why they wouldn't go for 2.
I see Streeter coming back in there, and doesn't look like their kicker's in there, so I believe they are going for 2.
A minute and 30 seconds showing on the Commonwealth Stadium clock. He sends Jeff Moore wide to the right side, Arbor to the left. Jimmy Streeter back to Kelsey Finch. In for 2. We got a tie ball game.
That's the same play they used Denny to score the touchdown on. And Streeter ran it to perfection again, and so did Kelsey Finch.
And there's a pause in the action now with the score, Tennessee 14, Kentucky 14.
Money Saver means never having to remember your passbook for a savings deposit or withdrawal. Money Saver means no charge for traveler's checks at Louisville Home Federal.
Money Saver means cash discounts at fine restaurants all over town.
Money Saver means instant identification for check cashing at Louisville Home Federal.
Money Saver means cash discounts on flowers.
Ask about Money Saver only at Louisville Home Federal. Money Saver can mean a lot to you.
Red Lobster is where America goes for seafood.
What makes Red Lobster so popular?
Over 30 delicious seafood reasons right on the Red Lobster menu.
Lobster, snapper, clams, flounder,
shrimp.
Generous platters of America's favorite seafoods.
At these prices, we'll be back.
Red Lobster is where America goes for seafood.
Come join us for dinner or lunch.
Tennessee has taken advantage of a Kentucky turnover here. John Bow fumbled a punt. Tennessee recovered just inside the 20-yard line and quickly took it in to score. Kelsey Finch going the last 9 yards, and Finch again over for the 2-point conversion to tie it up at 14-14 with a minute and a half to play in the first half. Here's Gaylor's kickoff. Keeps it on the ground. Freddie Williams at the 15. Freddie almost got outside and got away, got it back up to almost the 30-yard line. He'll spot it closer to the 28. So Kentucky will have to go 72 yards here to get another one on the board before halftime. Freddie Williams on the carry, trying to dance outside. Not much there for him.
We only have 1:16 to play, Denny, and the clock is running down, so it's going to be very difficult for Kentucky to even get the position for a field goal with that short of time.
And give Freddie Williams a gain of four there, make it second and six. Will Kentucky go to the air? Yes, Felix sir. Wilson, wide left. Derek Ramsey on that naked reverse. He's got no blockers there. Derek hit pretty good by Greg Jones, the linebacker. Danny Jenkins, the tackle, chased him down also.
It looks like Kentucky's going to be content to let the clock run down because they're not using any of their timeouts, and this would be a third down play, and unless Tennessee takes timeout and makes them punt, well, I believe the score is going to be 14-14 at half.
Kentucky does have three timeouts remaining if they wanted them. On third and one. Freddie Williams, a great open field tackle. Behind the line of scrimmage, Freddie Williams put down.
Tennessee is calling timeout, so Kentucky will have to punt, and we've got 4 seconds left, Denny.
I believe that was Roland James who came up from the left cornerback spot to make a great hit in the open field on Freddie Williams.
That was a fine play. Tennessee's defense has been playing just as well as their offense, and even though the score has got 14 points on the board, you can't take anything away from their defense. They played a fine game.
Got about 3 miles of cable down on the field today, Tom, for this telecast. Unfortunately, we don't have enough to get the monitors working up here in our booth, so we're having trouble picking up the tacklers with some monitor problems in our booth. But all apologies aside, it's a great football game. Kentucky 14, Tennessee 14, with 4 seconds showing on the clock. And now the offense is coming back out, and instead of risking a snap, I think they'll just have somebody fall on the football.
Well, you know, I hope they don't just do that because the ball would be down and Tennessee could call timeout and have 2 seconds left. So I think he's almost got to have a handoff, and now Kentucky is taking their second timeout in succession, it looks like. Now, in pro football, you can't do that, Denny. You can only take one. And a lot of times they try to do that sometimes to psych the field goal kicker, you know, in a crucial situation. In fact, I had a big argument once with Dick Butkus, and I didn't want to argue with him, I'll tell you that, but I finally convinced him he couldn't have two in a row.
Did you call Dick Butkus sir?
Yes, many, many times. But I think Kentucky's got to hand off or let Ramsey roll out. Now, if they roll out like that, why, the quarter will be over and the half will be over. But if they just fall down on it, he's got to blow it dead. It's very possible that Tennessee could have one play.
There's a shot of our announcing position here.
I'm saying that, but Tennessee doesn't have any more timeouts. Tennessee does not have any more timeouts, so they could just fall down on the ball.
Randy Brooks bringing it around the corner. As the horn sounds, Greg Jones put the hit on Randy Brooks, and that's the end of the first half with the score. Kentucky 14 and Tennessee 14. Washington, Denny Treese with you along with Tommy Bell. And Tommy, 30 minutes of great football still to be played in a tie ball game.
Well, this is the crucial third quarter. Kentucky's only allowed 7 points and outscored everybody fantastically. Tennessee's opponents have scored 60 and Tennessee's only scored 49. So Kentucky has the win and kicking off, and this quarter may determine who's going to win this football game, Denny.
Joe Bryant to boot it. Gary Moore at the 10. Trying to get outside. Cutting back up the middle now. Not much room there. Put down at about the 17-yard line. Bud Deal was there on the hit for Kentucky along with Dave Fedrowski, and who's getting off the bottom of the pile?
Well, Jerry Moore only had about a 7-yard return then, but that was because Kentucky's tremendous coverage on that. I haven't seen Kentucky cover a kickoff any better all year.
Ryan Kaysen, another of the 17 seniors playing their last game today from Coral Gables, Florida, in on that hit for Kentucky. Arbo wide to the right side now, Moore wide left. Kelsey Finch up the gut, good hard running across the 20 to the 22-yard line. Richard Jaffe made the hit for Kentucky. He's made a bunch of them today.
He really has. I believe he's caught up with Mike Martin. Mike's going to have to get on the ball to keep that leadership that he started this game with. Isn't it ironic, though, that Steve Porter, the only boy from Kentucky, is the one that recovered that fumble?
Second and six now, 30 seconds into the second half. Jimmy Streeter, the quarterback, gives to Jesse Briggs, and he's hit and brought down immediately. Kelly Kirchbaum on the stop there for Kentucky.
Kentucky's defense looks a little bit better at the start of this second half than it did at the start of the first half, so Tennessee's got a real crucial third down, and they're going to have a tough time making this one.
You can just about call out Richard Jaffe's name every time because he gets a hand on just about every time, runner every time he comes through there.
He either wants a solo or an assist one, didn't he?
Streeter on the option. He's got more than enough for the first down, diving forward across the 35-yard line. Rick Hayden touched him down.
He really impresses me. He has just as quick a feet as LeCount did last week at Florida. There wasn't any bad defensive play on Kentucky's part. That was just a good fake on Streeter and a tremendous run.
He was their JV quarterback last year, and anybody who saw Tennessee's JV team beat Kentucky right here a year ago saw him put on a great performance, Tommy.
Well, I didn't know that he was the JV quarterback, but I can tell you he's a varsity quarterback today.
Streeter has still got it. Jeff Hess diving him down across the 40-yard line. Kirchbaum there also on the stop at the 42.
Streeter made another fine play. He hesitated, and when he cut, he was in full speed. He seems to be able to start from a stop and then be in full speed, and he just picked up that yardage on his own.
13:03 remaining in the third period. Billy Arbo wide to the left side. Jeff Moore split out a few yards to the right. Kelsey Finch on a straight dive. Jaffe and Kirchbaum put him down again.
It's going to be short of a first down by about 6 inches or maybe even less than that.
They're going to measure this one, Tom. How many times have you done that?
Well, so many times, and you know, a lot of times when it's that close and then one of the quarterback who asked for it then, Streeter, while the officials will go ahead and give it to him, even though it's fairly obvious that it's not because the ball's right on the line and the chain is about a foot past the line. But when it's that close, if you're a good referee like Mr. Harper is, well, you'll go ahead and give him that measure.
If we have any viewers today who are...
Oh, it's closer than we thought. He's having to get down there and sight that. And he's going to roll that ball up there. It may be a first down. Wouldn't that be something? No, he missed it by about an inch. You see him holding his two fingers up? It was closer than I thought and closer than Mr. Harper. I know if he thought he was that close, he'd had a measurement.
I was just about to tell our viewers, Tommy, that if they're not familiar with that name, Tommy Bell, you officiated in the National Football League for how many years?
15 years, and I really enjoyed every minute of it, didn't
he? Okay, here we go. Third and inches. Streeter on the keeper, and he's got more than a few inches. Got about a yard.
He went right over his big center then. He didn't try to follow anybody at all except, and of course, Jaffe and the whole line were in there, but it was such a short gain while he made it with about a foot to spare. But that Shaw is a good football player. I can see where Johnny Majors is saying that he is a great player.
First and 10 from the 41 now. Streeter on the pitch back to Kelsey Finch. Jerry Blanton chased him down across the way, but not before Kelsey Finch took it to the 45.
Streeter made another good pitch, but Kelsey Finch did this one pretty much on his own this time. I think Kelsey gets the credit for that run. It's the same play that Tennessee scored both touchdowns on, and Kentucky's going to have to stop that play if they're going to beat Tennessee today.
The Kentucky's defense has really been depleted by injuries this season. Tennessee has had its share of injuries also. Second and two now from the 46. And it looks like Briggs has got enough.
Kentucky has number 70, who's third on their depth chart now, playing at left tackle for Kentucky. So you can see how deep Kentucky's having to go.
That other tackle spot is the one that's really been snake bit this year, Tommy. They've had Bobby Winkle and Tim Gooch injured, and Jerry Blanton injured last week. He's playing today. Earl Wilson, who backs him up, had a bunch of stitches in his hand this week. It's just been a snake bit position.
The officials are calling a timeout now so that the head linesman can get the people back off the sideline on the Kentucky side, and they're moving back a couple of our coaches and some spectators over there, and so that's what the delay that is for right now. But he'll wind it up and we'll start going.
We're in Kentucky territory at the 43-yard line, 10 minutes and 56 seconds with the clock running now. Quick look in pass. He's got his man, the tight end, Reggie Harper, dragging Rick Hayden with him to the 20-yard line. Well, Harper's been his favorite receiver all season, and he did it again.
Now, this is a great pass by Streeter and a great catch. It's just a simple jump up and throw to your tight end just going out. He makes a fine catch, and Kentucky has to make a fine defensive play here to stop him. He's a big man, Denny, and he runs that football like some of the big tight ends in pro football do.
Reggie's got to be regarded one of the best tight ends in the Southeastern Conference, although he is just a freshman. First and 10 from the 23. They spotted it at the 23. Streeter back up the gut. Look at him go. Dallas Owens put him down at the 10-yard line.
Well, that's another fine play by the quarterback Streeter, and Tennessee's taking it to Kentucky, and maybe this is the third quarter that's going to give them momentum. Watch Streeter on this run. He fakes to his fullback coming in and cuts out over to the left and then makes a hard cut back to the right, which almost springs him loose. It takes another fine defensive play by Kentucky's great defensive team, and if it hadn't been for Dallas Owens coming over there, I might believe he had been gone, didn't he?
First and 10 balls. Kelsey Finch. Now, great job of faking by Jimmy Streeter. He pitched it back to his tailback, and we got down to the 5-yard line. James Ramey brought down the ball carrier, Jesse Briggs.
I thought Finch had the football, too. He fooled me. That was a great fake, and then he pulled it back out and gave it to Briggs. Well, Kentucky's going to have to be fighting for their lives as Tennessee is taking it to them in this crucial third quarter.
Second and six. Harbo very wide to the right side. Everybody else in tight. Good tackle by Kelly Kirchbaum there.
Kelly laid the wood to him that time. That's the way Kelly's been playing a lot all year, and he came through that gap and just really put it on him. That's a great tackle, Kelly.
Briggs had no place to go once Kelly Kirchbaum got a hand on him. Richard Jaffe slowed him up a little bit, and then Kirchbaum said, "You're not going any further." Now Jeff Moore is back in and Aguilar out. Offensively for Tennessee on third and five. Kentucky jumped. It appeared they were back, and then the flags went down. Let's see.
There probably was contact. It's too hard from see where our booth is, but there's probably contact is why they killed the play and threw the flag. And I believe it's going to be a penalty, an illegal motion against Tennessee. So they caused Kentucky to jump, and that's a big break for the Kentucky Wildcats and a bad break for the Tennessee Volunteers.
Apparently there was not contact when the first man came across, Tommy, and then the offensive lineman raised up and caused him to come back over that second time.
That's exactly what happened. Tennessee's left tackle, you can see him move, and he cannot do that, and that's what caused the penalty.
Third and 10 now, very costly penalty. Streeter to throw. Owens on a blitz. Dallas Owens was coming. He got a hand on him, and then Richard Jaffe made sure of it. Another big defensive play, but credit it to the daring of Dallas Owens.
Well, that's Dallas Owens and Richard Jaffe, too. This is why Dallas Owens is a pro prospect in my mind. He's so quick. When he's on the blitz, he just gets in there almost before you can even know it. He even went past a blocker that time, too. And that's a great play by the Kentucky defense, and we're going to have a field goal attempt, Denny.
Jim Gaylor on to try it now from the 29, make it a 39, well, closer to the 38-yard field goal. is no good. The second time that Gaylor has been within his range but missed today. There's a pause in the action now with the score, Kentucky 14, Tennessee 14.
This is Church's fried chicken. Looks good, doesn't it? And it is good, from the inside out. It's good on the inside because it's marinated to make it nice and tender and full of flavor. It's good on the outside because it's double dipped to give it the crispy crust that really locks the flavor in. Well, there you have it. Hey, why don't you have it? Church's Fried Chicken. Good from the inside out.
Citizens Fidelity didn't invent freedom, but we have found a way to bring you more of it with Service Tree Banking. Check and save at Service Tree's growing at consolidated sales and just about every convenient food mart in town. Get the new freedom of Service Tree Banking by opening a checking and savings account at Citizens Fidelity. And don't forget to follow through.
Seven minutes and 51 seconds to play in the third period now with Kentucky in their power formation. Everybody in tight. Randy Brooks on the carry, and look at him go across the 25 to the 27-yard line. Good blocking on that left side. Chris Bolton brought him down. Tommy Dornbrook leading the blocking.
It looked like Joe Dupree got a good block on that play, too, and Randy Brooks made a fine run. Joe's coming right in there, and he made a good block on that. Good, fine play, and that gave Randy a little more running room.
You're absolutely right. Dupree knocked one down. Second and three now from the 27. Nothing fancy by Kentucky here. Two tight ends. Freddie Williams on the carry. Stood him up and pushed him back at the 30.
Tennessee went from their own 20 that time, Denny, and it ate up almost 7 minutes on the clock because they started with 14:30 and ended up 7:51.
It is a Kentucky first down.
Freddie Williams got that on his own initiative, too. Boy, he was stopped about a yard or two short, and he just kept right on going. He's really impressing me every time he gets a hold of that ball.
I'm also very impressed with this freshman linebacker for Tennessee, Chris Bolton. Lionel Stewart has played a lot this year, but Chris Bolton, I think, has won himself a spot. Going to be around there for a long time. Joe Dupree, with his usual hard running, still surging forward to almost the 34-yard line. Greg Jones, the other linebacker, spearheading that tackle.
Tennessee's got a lot of freshmen playing today that we're going to be looking at Kentucky for a long time, and I know that's the basis that Johnny Majors will be building this team on. I don't think I've given Coach Kersey enough credit, you know, on our telecast. I think he's just done the best job that's ever been done in this Southeastern Conference in bringing this Kentucky team up to here.
Second and six now, Wildcats. Ramsey still got it. Look at him drag tacklers with him across the 40-yard line for another Kentucky first down.
Well, Denny, it's just another typical Kentucky run by Derek Ramsey. And as I said in the LSU game, Derek, you must light up Coach Kersey's life. And I tell you, you've lit my life up in these games that I've been calling. I'm just so proud to have been a part to see you play like you're playing.
As it turned out, the left cornerback, Roland James, had to make a saving tackle. Felix Wilson in now, and he's wide to the left side. Straight up the gut. Joe Dupree bounces off a couple of tacklers, and the whistle had blown. Joe was out in the open field, and the fans don't like it.
Well, now, I can see why the Kentucky fans might not like that. Now, in pro football, we'd have a slower whistle. But I think in college, the officials have to have a slow, faster whistle, and I think he was stopped, and... You know, if that had been Tennessee, they would have been griping if they hadn't blown it. So it just depends on who you're rooting for.
So give Joe Dupree a gain of one, make it second and nine. Prosper wide to the left side. Nord split out of several yards to the right. Freddie Williams on the counter play, and look at him go. The Kentucky runners are doing it with reckless abandon today, Tommy. They're not holding anything back. There's no tomorrow for them. No bowl games this year. Kim Logan on the hit.
Well, Freddie Williams made 5 yards on just sheer guts and determination then, because he was had four men holding him every step that he took, and he just took them for 5 yards.
Johnny Chavis in defensively now for Tennessee, number 46.
Here's another one of those crucial third downs. It's third and five, and this will be tough to make.
On on the option. Ramsey cuts it back inside and dives, and he didn't get enough.
He didn't have anywhere to go then. That was a fine play by Greg Jones. Those linebackers, Tennessee, both of them is good. Greg and that freshman. Who's the freshman you were telling
Bolton,
me?
Chris Bolton.
I think you called it right. He's going to be a fine linebacker for three more years.
Roland James back deep to receive now with Kevin Kelly on to punt.
He's got the wind with him, and he's kicking from his 49. This is a good time to get a good one away.
He hit it pretty good. Roland James at the 12. Pedrowski was down there first, and they put him down at the 11. Rob Cheney also downfield in hurry for Kentucky. Pedrowski was the first man down. There's timeout on the field now, and we'll return with more action following this. From the 10-yard line now, the Tennessee balls go on the attack. Kelsey Finch on the carry, and on the slant play, he's got about four out to the 14.
Blanton's back in there and almost caught him behind the line. He was the one that hit him first. It's amazing, you know, you told me you were out at practice and Blanton was on crutches and he's playing today, and you told me it would be a miracle, and it is a miracle to see that boy playing football today.
Although Jerry didn't think it would be a miracle. He said, I'll be there. Straight up the middle, Kelsey Finch across the 15 to the 17-yard line. Richard Jaffe had a hand on the tackle again, along with Jerry Blanton.
You know, I tell you, Jaffe is there all the time, but old Blanton was there too. You know, I think Jerry Blanton is a great pro prospect, and Kentucky has a lot of them this year. Derek Ramsey, Art Steele, Dallas Owens, and Blanton, in my books, are top pro prospects.
Big play for Tennessee now. Third down and four from the 17-yard line. Nate Sumter on the pitch back from Streeter. Close to the first down. Let's see where they mark it. Johnny Bow and Jeff Hess knocked him out of bounds.
It's going to be very close, and I think they'll have to measure this one, and they're going to measure it and bring it out. It's just going to be a matter of inches whether he makes it or not. But wasn't that a great play by Streeter, where he faked that pass and then made that pitch out? He wouldn't have even gotten close to a first down if he hadn't been able to do the way he did it.
Mike Martin and Dallas Owens over there to get a good, close look at it.
Well, this is very crucial. If Tennessee has to punt into this win with 2:47, if they make the first down, it's very possible they'll have the wind to their back. And they made it just by about the toe of the football got it, Denny, and that's it. That's a very good break for the Tennessee Volunteers.
We'll repeat what we told you before this one ever got started. Tennessee has never lost seven games in a season. They don't want to make this the year. Johnny Majors and his crew don't want to be remembered for that distinction.
Well, this team is playing with great emotion, and they're playing like a great football team, not one that's lost six games.
Nate Sumter on the carry, bounced off of one man and still running up to the 25-yard line. James Ramey finally got him down.
I don't know how much Sumter's been playing this year, but boy, he has impressed me today. He has picked up 4 and 5 yards every time he's gotten that ball, a lot of times on his own.
Mike Martin got off the bottom of that stack for Kentucky there after the gain of four. Make it 2nd and 6. 2 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Arbo goes wide left. Jeff Moore split to the right side. Streeter keeps it and brought down by Jerry Blanton. David Stevens also. It was David Stevens, I believe, 82, not 92.
I tell you, that's hard to see, Denny, and David Stevens made a great play on that. He sized it up just right, and he is so quick and so fast that he didn't go for that fake then and made a fine play.
So we're back to that same 3rd and 4 situation, this time from the 27-yard line.
Kentucky's defense was almost caught off balance then. Tennessee came out of the huddle so quick.
Faked it to Sumter. Throwing intended for the tight end. John Murphy was the intended receiver.
It hit him right on the numbers, Denny. That's a bad spot, I guess, sometimes to hit him, because the pass was good and he just dropped it. That's a big break for the Wildcats.
So Colquitt on the punt now, averaging 45.8 on the season.
He's having to punt into the wind again. He's had that almost all day every time he's kicked.
Johnny Bow calling for the fair catch here at the 40-yard line.
That's only about a 32-yard kick, so you can see what the factor this win is with him averaging 45 and only getting a 32-yard kick.
Well, it's time out here in Lexington with the score, Kentucky 14, Tennessee 14.
We have fresh ideas at Red Barn, like a salad bar for you.
Red Barn's big new salad bar is paradise. It's a garden of eating.
I come to Red Barn because I miss my wife's salad.
Every chance I get.
We have fresh ideas at Red Barn.
Why is Red Barn salad like a broken record?
You can go back and go back and go back.
And I'm going back.
My girlfriend, she puts plenty of onions on her salad. That way I can always find her in the dark.
Fresh ideas at Red Barn, like a salad bar for you.
Cook adds life to everything that makes your living nice. Cook adds life, and everybody wants a little life. Oh yeah,
cook adds life. Cook adds life. Cook adds life. Cook adds life.
Cook adds life to everything that makes your living nice.
Full house set for Kentucky now on first and 10 from the 40. Ramsey behind Freddie Williams. Cuts it to the outside and got about three. Knocked out of bounds by a whole host of white shirts. Roland James was there, the cornerback, along with Greg Jones.
Well, Kentucky still just thrown one pass, and I believe that they're going to start opening up with a little passing now in this game. It really is amazing that they've only thrown the one pass. But this third quarter's coming to an end. Now, the defense has held up their end, but their offense hasn't been scoring like they have all year, Denny.
Will Grant, the center, comes out over the football. Straight T formation for Kentucky. Two tight ends in the game. Freddie Williams on the carry. Good blocking on that right side, and he's got enough for the first down. Into Tennessee territory at the 48.
Let's watch Freddie Williams on this. Kentucky must be convinced that they can run on the Tennessee's left side of their line and their right, because they've been running there all day and getting good yardage. And here comes Freddie Williams again. He's tried that about 10 times today and been running hard, and another good run and a lot of good blocking on that right side of the Kentucky line. Tom Dornbrook.
Dan Fowler got a dandy for him.
He sure did.
They've marked it at the 49-yard line in Tennessee territory. Ramsey cuts it inside and got just a yard.
Derek, if he could have kept his feet then, he had it going against the grain and might have made one of those long, famous runs that he's for, but his feet slipped right out from under him. He tried to cut so quick.
The linebackers for Tennessee have played excellently today, Bolton and Jones. Jones that time did not overcommit himself. He let Ramsey commit himself and then put him down. Second and eight now from the 47-yard line. 28 seconds remaining, third period. Down. A great play by Kim Logan, number 95, 6'2", 210 senior from Birmingham, Alabama.
Number 34 is Hawkins, and in that Parks. Let's watch number 34 here as he makes a block on this end, and looks like he's got him, but he still gets up and gets Ramsey. Fine play.
And that's the end of the third period. We'll return with the final quarter of action in just a moment. On an obvious passing situation now, third and 11, Kentucky has put in their best passer, Mike Deaton, the sophomore from Greensburg, number one. 15 minutes of football still to be played, and we're all knotted up at 14 points apiece. Third down and 11. You can bet Tennessee will be playing this loosely, Tommy.
I'm sure everybody in the stands knows this is going to be a pass, and Coach Kersey might cross this up and have a draw play.
Felix Wilson goes wide to the left side. Kentucky in the double wing slot. Deaton straight back. Well, they were going to throw a little delay draw there, or a delay screen, I should say, to the tight end, David Trosper, and there was not much room to run it.
It looks like he threw it just a little bit in front of Trosper, but it was one that he could have caught probably, and I'm sure he feels kind of badly about it. Maybe Mike Deaton does also, but it was set up well and a well-calculated play. I sure wish he could have caught it.
Kevin Kelly just gets it away, goes down again, but no whistle again. No flag. Fair catch at the 20-yard line. What do you think, Tommy?
Well, Coach Perry Moss was pretty upset about that, and I'd have to say that time it wasn't a movement of the kicker, and it could have possibly been called running into the kicker that time. I know Perry Moss wanted to call. He threw his hat down, and of course, he's the offensive coach, and I'm sure he wanted to have a first down.
Fran Kersey has to change hats a few times during the season. He has a tendency to stomp on his at times, but Fran is a very calm coach normally on the sideline.
Yes,
he keeps his demeanor at all times, but his only show of emotion is that throwing of the hat. Right up the middle, and not much there. Earl Wilson stood his man up, about a 2-yard gain.
That's a freshman for Kentucky, and he's playing a fine football game, and I think you're going to see a lot of Earl Wilson from now on in this Southeastern Conference.
As I said, he's playing with a lot of stitches in his hand, result of one of several injuries that have plagued this Kentucky defensive team all season long. A gain of 2 on the play, make it 2nd and 8.
Kentucky's injuries would make, believe it or not.
Streeter has gone all the way at quarterback. Fumble on the play, or no? No, he did not. Richard Jaffe just got to Streeter before he could do anything with it.
Jaffe must have heard us say that Noonan was playing maybe a little bit better than he was, because he's come out this second half and just played a super game.
A lot of pride on that Tennessee bench today. 2nd down now. 10 yards to go.
This is third and ten.
Danny. I'm sorry, 3rd and 10. Look at that. They got more than enough.
Well, on that play, Jaffe gambled a little bit, and I think he came just to the opposite side on him, and it left a little hole in there, and the linebacker didn't pick it up. So Tennessee Sumter is really coming on through there and made about 14, didn't he?
That he did. Spotted now at the 34-yard line, 1st and 10, Tennessee. Arbo comes wide to the left side. Throwing deep. He's got his man Moore, dropped the football. Jeff Moore dropped the football. He had his man beat. It was a sure touchdown. Johnny Bow was about 3 steps behind him, but Jeff Moore dropped it.
Well, Streeter threw a beautiful pass, and nobody's sorrier than Jeff Moore that he dropped that one, because it might have been a touchdown, because he had a couple of steps and it just slipped right through his hands. A beautiful pass by Tennessee quarterback Streeter.
Now it's 2nd and 10, 13-10 to go in the ball game. Arbo wide left. Throwing again, intended for Arbo. He's got it. Plenty of room in front of him. He got by Dallas Owens. Finally brought down by Bud Deal at the Kentucky 34-yard line.
Well, Larry Carter gambled then, either for an interception or to knock it down, and he missed it, and Arbo got it and kept in bounds and picked up about 20 more yards after he caught that ball. Watch Larry Carter gamble on this play now over there on the sideline. Larry goes over there for it, misses it. Arbo stays in and picks up a lot of yardage. Fine run, Arbo, after you caught that ball. He's a fine young man.
1st and 10, Tennessee from the 34. Nate Sumter up the gut. He got 3 to the 31. Richard Jaffe on the hit.
Well, it's getting down to where we're going to decide out who's going to win this football game now, because if Tennessee can take it on in, it's going to be awful tough for Kentucky to come back. And the defense, so many times in one game for us, they're being put to the test again, just like they were down in Florida last week.
2nd and 7 now. Faked it to Sumter, and Streeter is hit and dropped at the 32-yard line. Bud Deal was the first man to grab him. Blanton is also there. And James Ramey, the left tackle.
Bud Deal made a fine play, and of course, that's the way Kentucky's been playing defense all year, that great pursuit and gang tackling. And it looks like they've made up their mind they're going to try to stop Tennessee right here.
3rd and 8. We told you Kentucky had given up only 5 touchdowns all season rushing. Tennessee has 2 already. They would like to make it 3 on this drive. Streeter to throw. Hit and dropped behind the line at the 41-yard line. Richard Jaffe came storming in to bring him down again.
Well, Kentucky had the blitz on then with Dallas Owens, and he just as soon as Dallas hit him, then Jaffe came. So I think that was a great call by the defense.
Going to make it a very long field goal try. They're going to spot it down at the about the 47, so make it a 57-yard field goal attempt.
He has the wind with him, and I don't know how far he can kick it, but it's going to be close.
That's going to be long enough. It's good. A 57-yard field goal by Jim Gaylor has put Tennessee in front here, 17-14. There's a pause in the action, and we'll be right back. 2 minutes and 53 seconds is all that remains to be played in this football season for Kentucky as Gaylor kicks off. Robert Hawkins watches it sail over his head out of the end zone, and Kentucky will start from the 20-yard line. They'll have to go 80 yards to get back in this thing. They trail 17-14, 10:53 to go. And Tommy Bell, I have to think that the reason Kentucky has not thrown is because of the injured shoulder of Derek Ramsey, and they're going to go now with Mike Deaton, the sophomore.
I think that's exactly right, because Kentucky tried to run it out, and Derek just wasn't able to throw that football. He made one pass in that first half to Felix Wilson. But I want to tell you, when that field goal went through those uprights, it was just like a bomb going off on that Tennessee bench. And Tennessee's emotionally high, and Kentucky's going to have to play their very best to win it.
Chris Hill, number 22, in at left halfback for Kentucky. Deaton on the roll. He's got time. Throwing deep. Wilson is there. Felix Wilson into Kentucky territory at the 45-yard line. Deaton completes the pass. Yep. Junior Reed rode him out of bounds.
I want to tell you, that ignited all the Kentucky fans, too, and that's the first time, really, this half they've had to lie. Deaton rolls out to his left, finds Felix Wilson down there on the sideline, makes a tremendous pass, and I hope we're going to see a lot more of that in the next years to come.
You better believe we will. Junior Reed, the man who made the saving tackle, is coming out of the lineup now for Tennessee, being carried off. Appeared to hurt his right arm. Deaton on the give there to Hill. He got almost to the 40. Chris Hill, by the way, Tommy, has averaged 5.5 yards per carry for Kentucky this year. He is not starting today, but getting his chance now, and he's had a great average all season.
He sure has. Kentucky's got the momentum now, and with Deaton's threat on passing, he's going to open up that running, I believe, and I think you're going to see the Cats give the balls all they can have.
Second and 7. Randy Brooks on the carry. Hit and driven back at the 40-yard line.
Well, I said he was going to give them all they could handle, and I tell you, the Tennessee defense swarmed just like Kentucky's been doing.
Greg Jones and Chris Bolton, the two linebackers, continue to play sensationally for Tennessee. Derek Ramsey back in at quarterback now for Kentucky on 3rd and 5. From the 40-yard line, 9 minutes and 47 seconds and the clock moving.
I look for Derek to roll out to the right on this play, and it could be a pass or a run.
Derek has got it. Diving for the first down. Derek Ramsey dove to get it. Chip Linebarrier brought him down with help from Roland James, the cornerback, but not before Ramsey got the first down.
That was a great play by Derek Ramsey. He did just the opposite of what I thought he would do. It was a quarterback draw play, and they did some great blocking, and Derek Ramsey ran his usual great set.
The fans just gave him a standing ovation as if to say, we're going to miss you, big guy. This is his last game along with 16 other seniors. Ramsey on the rollout. Finally goes out of bounds. Didn't gain much, perhaps a couple.
We had student body right that time, Denny, and he didn't gain too much, but it looked like he might have had a chance to break it open.
Well, they're spotting it inside the 30 now, so they're going to give him forward progress to the 29-yard line. And it'll be 2nd and 6. Give him a gain of 4. Felix Wilson in now, and Greg Nord out. So Kentucky will have Trosper and Wilson, their two fine wideouts, in together. Wilson goes wide left. Trosper's put to the right side. The backs are Brooks, Dupree, and Hill behind Ramsey. Chris Hill got a good block from Dan Fowler and took it inside the 25 to the 23-yard line.
It's going to be close for a first down, and I believe they may have to measure this one.
Jim Noonan made the stop on Chris Hill.
They are going to measure. It's that close, Denny. You know, I think we've got to give Derek Ramsey, I've been praising him all the time, but he's playing hurt today, and that's even more to his credit that he's playing such a great game with that bad shoulder.
They've had a lot of guys playing with injuries this season. Guys have simply had to. Kelly Kirchbaum and Blanton both showing tremendous courage today to even be on the football field. About 6 inches short of a first down, Tommy.
Well, I think that, in my mind, it might be a break for Kentucky because that gives them a chance to pick up some extra yardage with a good down. And, of course, I'm sure maybe if I'd been the coach, I'd want it to be a first down.
Tell you, if I was from the state of Tennessee, I'd be mighty proud this afternoon.
They've got to be holding their heads 10 feet tall today. They've played a tremendous football game. No matter who wins it, both teams have played a great football game.
Third and 6 inches for a first down. Everybody in tight. Joe Dupree for the first down.
He made it easy.
I think Greg Jones may end up this ball game with at least 20 tackles like he had last year. Number 53 seems to be in on every one for Tennessee.
He has just played a tremendous game. I see the Tennessee put their big tackle Turnbow back in there, and that may be a big factor and make Kentucky run that other way.
6'8", it's hard to run over him. Wilson wide to the left side on first and 10 from the 22. Ramsey on the quarterback draw, and he got just a yard. Jim Noonan pushed him back with help from Jones.
That may have been that same quarterback draw that Ramsey made the first down on, but I really believe they missed a handoff that time because Derek was too hesitant in going on with the draw play. The other time, there wasn't any hesitation right at all. He ran right with it.
Give him a gain of one at second and nine. There have been 9 ties in this series through the years. If Kentucky has to resort to a field goal, it could be 10. Joe Dupree running off the right side. Look at him push his man forward to the 10-yard line. Roland James brought him down. He almost ran right over Clark Duncan, the safety man. Joe Dupree just lowered his head, Tommy.
Joe Dupree made a great run here, and he's made 2 or 3 today, but this is probably one of the greatest runs he's made all year. And I thought maybe if he could, he runs so hard with his feet behind him, and that gives him that extra 4 yards. Joe, that was just a tremendous run. We're going to miss you here at Kentucky.
And luckily for Kentucky, it's first and 10 at the 11, so they could get another first down inside the 2-yard line. This is Dupree, straight up the middle, very hard running. He just pulled his way to almost the 5-yard line, 7 minutes and 10 seconds remaining.
I believe Joe wants it very badly, and the way he's run these last 2 plays, you couldn't find a better fullback.
And he's leading cheers. Jesse Turnbow helped to drag him down, and I do mean drag. He had to be dragged down.
Joe almost has his whole jersey torn off. His shoulder pads are all exposed. The only thing that you can probably see is his numbers.
He would give you the shirt off his back for a victory today, Tommy. Trasper wide to the left side. Nord to the right. Second and 5 from the 6-yard line. It's Dupree again to the 1.
He's down there close for a first down.
They had to get to the 1-yard line for a first down.
Looks like the line judge is marking it on the 2-yard line, so it's going to be about 1 yard short, Denny.
Noonan and Jones again on the stop for Tennessee. Dupree finally going out, and the trucker, Chuck Servino, another of the seniors for Kentucky, in at fullback.
I think the referee sent Joe out to get a new jersey on, and now it's fourth down.
Third and one. Servino for the touchdown. He's been pushed back. The referee did not signal. It appeared he went over, but let's see.
They marked it on about the 6-inch, Denny. They did not give him a touchdown.
It is a first down, Kentucky.
First down, but not a touchdown.
Did you think he went over? I certainly did.
Well, it looked here like it to me. Of course, I'm kind of prejudiced, and I thought he got on, but the referee's right on top of it, and I'd have to go with that referee's call. Both the head linesman and line judge both called him about 6 inches short. But there's not any doubt in my mind that Kentucky's going to score now, and that's not taking anything away from the great Tennessee defense either.
It hardly even looks like 6 inches. It looks like the nose of the football is practically on the line.
It sure does.
Dupree is back in now, first and goal. Ramsey sneaks. There it is. That is a touchdown. Kentucky has gone in front, and the crowd goes absolutely wild.
Well, you can see nothing but blues. And I tell you, when Ramsey scores, I guess this is probably one of the happiest Kentucky crowds that I've ever seen, Denny, and there have been a lot of them when they played Tennessee. But the way Tennessee came back and went on top, for Kentucky to take that football and just drive it all the way down, it's just tremendous.
Joe Bryant to attempt the extra point from the hold of Billy Williams. If he makes it, a field goal cannot tie. He made it. 21-17. Tennessee will have to score a touchdown to win. It's timeout, and we'll return with more action following this. A one-yard dive by Derek Ramsey has just climaxed an 80-yard drive by Kentucky as the Wildcats go in front 21-17, 5 minutes and 29 seconds remaining.
Danny, they took 5 minutes and 24 seconds doing that, so we're still in a ball game, and anybody can win it.
Taken by one of the upbacks at the 20-yard line. Down he goes at the 23. Bud Deal on the hit for Kentucky.
Tennessee has plenty of time, and I expect you're going to see running and passing mixed up. I don't believe they'll have to get desperate and start throwing on every down.
It's Jesse Briggs who caught the kickoff and was downed after a return of a couple of yards. They'll spot it at the 24, first and 10. 5:25 to play in the game. Many of the 57,000-plus fans on their feet now. Streeter off that right side. Hit hard, but not before he got it across the 30-yard line.
That was another fine play by Streeter. He put the ball in the fullback's gut, pulled it out, and picked up about 7-8 yards.
Jerry Blanton had to drag him down after the gain of 8, second and 2.
Well, Kentucky's defense is going to be put to another test because this is exactly like the situation we had down in Florida with just about this much time, and Tennessee's going to really put it to them.
Streeter pitching back to Sumter. Look at him go across the midfield stripe.
Rick Hayden. I think Rick Hayden's the one that pulled him down, and he made a tackle that he had him pinned into the sideline. I don't think he's going to go all the way, but if he'd have missed him, he'd have gone all the way.
First and 10 balls from the 48-yard line now. Straight up the gut, Nate Sumter to the 45-yard line.
Well, I said that I didn't think Tennessee would have to pass on every down. They haven't passed yet. But I believe they're going to have to go to the air before this drive is over if they're going to try to get in position to score the winning touchdown.
4 minutes and 16 seconds showing on the clock. It's running.
It couldn't be any more exciting, Denny. A typical Kentucky-Tennessee game, and both teams just playing great.
He faked it to Finch. Streeter is down. Richard Jaffe is one of the men that's on him at the 45. Jerry Blanton is on top also. What a game Richard Jaffe has played.
And, you know, I think you've got to give Blanton a lot of credit. You know, the guy that couldn't even walk without a crutch on Thursday, and there he is out there being right on top of the plate.
Not heavily recruited. Out of Toledo, Ohio, Kentucky's mighty glad he spent the last 4 years here. Third and 6. One of the big plays of the season. The draw play to Sumter. Tackled behind the line. He got up for about 3 yards, and that's all. Jerry Blanton had a hand on him, and then James Ramey put him down.
And Richard Jaffe was over there also. Golly, he's just playing himself some football game.
Jerry Blanton being carried off now by his teammate Jeff Hess on the far sideline. Well short of the first down, about 4 yards short.
We got a timeout for Tennessee. Streeter certainly didn't want to make this decision. With fourth down and about 4, they had to call over here and see what Majors wanted to do.
Timeout on the field now, and we'll return in just a moment.
Trying to steal home with a great deal? You're safe at Perkins. Chrysler Plymouth.
Hey guys, Grandma's got a surprise for you. There's a whole batch of them. How many are there?
12. Come on, come on, come on, and taste the Pepsi way. Come on, come on, come on, and have a Pepsi day. The laughter of a world at play. Memories of a Pepsi day. Come on, come on, and have a Pepsi day.
Watch as power-driven air browns and cooks meats faster, juicier, in this extraordinary Gen Air power oven. And the extraordinary Gen Air grill range rotisses, griddles, and grills meat, venting smoke and odors direct to outdoors. Meat cooks the way you want it with the extraordinary Gen Air grill range.
See your local Jennair appliance dealer today.
Is 3 minutes and 15 seconds away from doing that. 3 minutes and 15 seconds away from winning their ninth straight and going 10-1 on the year. They only lost to Baylor. They've beaten North Carolina, West Virginia, Penn State, Mississippi State, LSU, Georgia, VPI, Vandy, Florida, and hoping to make it Tennessee. The Vols coming off a very disappointing 43-14 loss to Ole Miss last week. But they've given it everything they've got today.
This might be the biggest play of the game right here, Denny, because if Kentucky holds, I believe they're going to win the game.
Fourth and four. Streeter to throw. Decides to run it. He didn't get there. Short of the first down, a stack of blue shirts. Earl Wilson is there. Kelly Kirchbaum is there. Kirchbaum made the big, big play, and he's limping off with his arm around his senior teammate, Mike Martin, now. Kentucky has done it again.
That's a great thrill for Kentucky with their injured men limping off, playing great football. But I want to tell you, Dallas Owens had great coverage on Arbo down here, and the defensive secondary made that play besides the tackling that Kirchbaum and the other boys that you called put it on. So I want to take my hats off to Kentucky secondary on that play.
Kentucky needs only to run out the clock now. They're going to have a couple of first downs in this drive. Joe Dupree diving across the 40 to the 42-yard line.
Well, I won't say that the game is over, Denny, but Tennessee's going to have a very rough time. They only have two timeouts left, and Kentucky can get one first down. I believe they're going to put this game away and be the first time they've ever gone undefeated in the Southeastern Conference.
Second and eight now. Nord goes wide to the left side, Trosper to the right. Chris Hill on the carry to the 45. Danny Jenkins on the stop.
This is a crucial play for Kentucky because if they make this first down, why, they can seal it. It's going to be tough for Tennessee to come back, but anytime you've got anything on that clock, you've got time to come back. For example, that long pass that was dropped.
Kentucky would like to have to not punt the ball. Don't chance a bad snap, but they've got to get 5 yards on this play. Ramsey kept it himself. Short of the first down, the ball is fumbled. Tennessee has got it. Ramsey fumbled the football, and Tennessee is going to have another shot.
Well, we just said, if there's any time left on that scoreboard, why, you've got a chance to win. And there was a fumble. Who would have thought that Ramsey would fumble? I don't even remember him fumbling all year.
1 minute and 56 seconds remaining. Okay. Kelly Kirchbaum, who limped off a moment ago, is back on the field. Sumpter on the draw play, trying to get wide, dives to the 40-yard line. A gain of five, it'll be second and five. The clock running at 148, 147, 146.
And it's a factor now, Denny, and Tennessee's got two timeouts left, and it's a big factor. I don't know what Richard Jaffe's doing. It looks like he's lined up in the Tennessee backfield there. Now he gets back over on our side. He's been in it all day. Maybe he thought he ought to go in the huddle.
They spotted it at the 41, second and six. A minute and a half to play. Streeter throwing to the tight end again, Reggie Harper. He's now all the way down to the 25-yard line. Rick Hayden knocked him off his feet at the 25.
Now the clock is stopped for that first down, but as soon as the referee comes away, he'll wind it up, and there he goes. So there goes the clock again, and it's a matter of seconds. You know, gosh, I thought that Kentucky probably had won the game when they stopped him on that fourth play, and here they are right back in it.
Kyle Aguilar, 87, in at tight end now for Tennessee. The draw play again to Sumpter. He's got some running room. And is up to the 23-yard line.
Tennessee's calling timeout now. They have one left, and it's 1:03 to go. So, I don't know. I've got cold chills down my spine like I just before. This is just a great college football game. It's football at its very best, and I love pro football.
Well, there is a timeout, and we'll be back with the score. Kentucky 21, Tennessee 17.
Smith's Furniture. When it comes to fine furniture, appliances, and carpeting, it's the name you can't forget.
Who?
Smith's Furniture. That's who.
Now, take your choice of open stock bedrooms by Famous Broyhill. Choose rich oak or charming French style. Basic pieces now priced from only $98.
Smith's Furniture. When it comes to fine furniture, appliances, and carpeting, it's the name you can't forget.
Who?
Smith's Furniture. That's who.
When you apply for a loan, chances are you'd like an answer on it pretty quickly.
Take a seat.
If you deserve a loan, you deserve better than waiting for an answer. And waiting, and waiting. That's why Liberty National Bank offers you the 60-minute loan. Apply for an installment loan at Liberty, and we'll give you an answer in 60 minutes or less. Don't let anybody else hold you up.
Hey, what day is it anyway?
Come to Liberty for more help, more quickly.
Well, if the clock ticks 63 more times without Tennessee scoring, Kentucky will have wrapped up a 10-1 season. But don't count the Volunteers out. If you did earlier, they made a liar out of you. They've come back strong.
They made a liar out of me, and I'm proud of them. Gosh, I know everybody in Tennessee's proud of this Tennessee team. They've just played a tremendous game, and everybody in Kentucky's got to be proud of Kentucky. I have not seen one fan leave his seat from this game, and everybody that paid their money got their money's worth today.
He ought to be measured for a straitjacket if he left this thing. Second and six. Streeter wants to throw. Now tucks it and runs. The ball is fumbled. Kentucky's got it. Kentucky jumped on the football.
Kentucky's fans have gone wild. That's the second turnover.
Kelly Kirchbaum was there.
Let's see who gets this fumble for Kentucky.
Kirchbaum has just done so much for this team, and I think he got on that football. Let's watch it.
He played that. He hit Streeter first, and then I tell you, our monitor is so bad you just can't hardly see who got it. And I'd hate to call somebody that didn't get it, but they were all there, and the whole Kentucky defense deserved to get it. I'll tell you that.
We really have to apologize for our inability to read numbers today, but our monitors are just so fuzzy we can't see a number. Look how tightly Kentucky is bunched with the clock running. Tennessee has a timeout left, and they'll take it.
That's Tennessee's last timeout, and I just don't believe there's any way that Kentucky can lose it now, even though I say when there's seconds on the clock, anything can happen. But I think all they're going to do is just do like they did on the first down, have Ramsey fall down, and all the backs cover him up. Let me again give credit to Dr. Holt. I'd like to tell you, if you're not here today and you're watching our telecast, you'd be proud of your Volunteers. And our great president, Dr. Otis Singletary, would like to send his greetings to you. And we hope that Kentucky and Tennessee will meet many, many more times. There's the Kentucky bench, and there's Coach Kersey. I know he's happy now. And I see Coach Moss. He's even happy now when he was a little upset a few minutes ago. It's been a great year for the Kentucky Wildcats. Their coaching staff and all the players deserve all the credit in the world. Who would have believed, it's got to be believe it or not, Denny, with all those injuries, that Kentucky could have done the impossible this year, not be defeated in the Southeastern Conference.
It has definitely been a Cinderella season, and it looks like the slipper's going to fit when this thing's all over here. 49 seconds to go, and all Kentucky has to do is run out the clock from here. Tennessee out of timeouts. On the sidelines now, the Kentucky cheerleaders are running up and down with the coveted beer barrel, and it looks like it'll stay in Lexington for another year.
There are no more timeouts, and Kentucky gets down to 35, and they'll have to run just one more play. The referee declares the play ready with 33 seconds, so they will have to run one more play. Again, let me compliment the Tennessee Volunteers and Coach Majors. Everyone that on that team has got to feel like that they've played one of the very finest games for Tennessee.
Derek Ramsey lets his very large body fall over the ball. The last 8 seconds are ticking off the clock now.
That's it, Denny.
Kentucky has finished up a 10-1 season with a 21-17 victory over the Tennessee Vols, and we'll be right back at Commonwealth Stadium. Field Coach Kersey has come to the near sidelines with University of Kentucky Athletic Director Cliff Hagan, where a special presentation is going to be made, and there still aren't very many people leaving the field. You look at the Wildcat there, sitting on the beer barrel.
Well, Denny, I think everybody's staying in the stands and just savoring this victory. And if I had one word to sum up this whole game for both teams, it's courage. And I think that Tennessee showed a tremendous amount of courage, and Kentucky's defense showed a tremendous amount of courage after Ramsey's fumble. And I just can't compliment both squads enough for what a great football game that they play today. And this will go down in history as maybe one of the very greatest games that was ever played between these two fine schools.
And a lot of the credit, of course, has to go to guys who weren't even able to play in this game. Guys like Mike Saganos, who contributed so much all season long. There's Art Still coming over to be congratulated. A surefire All-American and a surefire first-round professional draft pick.
Well, Art Still played another great game. He sure reminds me of Bubba Smith on that commercial where he just grabs the whole backfield and starts throwing them out till he gets to the ball. And he is a surefire All-American, and he'll be a great pro player.
We'll try to pick up from our sideline microphones this presentation, if and when it occurs. Coach Kersey talking there with Art Still. And I imagine Coach Kersey is going to shed a tear or two tonight, thinking about these 17 seniors that won't be with him next year. I think Tommy Dornbrook is taking the beer barrel back home with him.
Tommy Dornbrook has so many cat's paws on his helmet that they can't even have a K on there. So he's had a tremendous year and had a great game in this game, and we're going to miss all of those seniors. You know, it's kind of sad to see seniors leave, and I know that he said that he was homesick at first, but he just didn't know what he would do after this game was over.
Will Grant is carrying it with him. Will is one of the real free spirits on this team, and if there's anything in it, Will may drink it.
I think all the Kentucky teams coming back out on the field, Denny, and, you know, I guess the whole squad deserves the accolades. Anything that we could say, it just wouldn't be enough for him.
Let's go down to the sideline, Mike, and see what we can pick up now.
Six.
Bart Kersee accepting the accolades of a, well, what is a near-capacity crowd still, Tommy?
Well, Denny, I've had a lot of thrills in my sports career, but I think this is really the biggest, to see two fine teams fight right tooth to toe.